Welcome to our Hybrid Heroes series. I have privilege to meet Arnaud Sartre tonight. He joined Toastmasters on the 1st of April 2013 to improve his speaking on the spot skills. He has held all of the District 91 elected officers' roles and is currently the immediate past district director. During lockdown, he led the district to a record number of distinguished clubs and supported the growth of 15 clubs. He is a member of two clubs, one corporate and one community. And he is a vice president of education of the latter. Professionally, Arnaud is a consultant in the life science industry, specializing in scientific IT and research and development digital transformation. Welcome, Arnaud.
Thank you, Marta. My pleasure to be here with you this evening.
I should also say that you had the privilege of setting up the hybrid committee as the District 91 director. And now we have an opportunity to find out a bit more from you as a hybrid person, as a person who is interested in hybrid. What has been your hybrid meeting experience and story?
Oh, this is a great question, and thank you, Marta, for asking. First of all, let me say thank you, first of all, to the entire hybrid committee, because when we embarked on this idea of a hybrid future during the last Toastmaster year, we had no idea whether this would be a success, whether this would be nothing, whether we would even be able to have hybrid meetings. Setting up those activities is something that starts from an idea and the team really run with it. And what I have seen come out of this committee in the past few weeks and months has only been tremendous. Plenty of advice, plenty of ideas, and this video series is certainly a great idea. My hybrid story starts back in 2006. And 2006 is a long time ago. And I believe this is also the year where Cisco came up with telepresence. And I was fortunate enough to work for a company that had introduced this type of meeting at great cost, I should add, to our employees so that we could have pretty much as close to in-person activities whilst being separated with thousands of miles. So this is really where my hybrid experience comes from, 2006, so 14, 15 years ago today. This is just an incredible when I was looking at when I was first exposed to this type of interaction. Now, much more close to our heart and what we do within Toastmasters and District 91 in particular, my first hybrid experience was actually towards the end of my term as district director, if not actually my last day or my penultimate day as district director, when I attended a meeting at Hamwick Speakers. This was a tremendous experience for a number of reasons. Well, first of all, traveling all the way to the New Forest to attend this meeting in person was an incredible experience in itself. But more importantly, the amount of work and effort the club had put in order to come up with this experience with dozens of members, both online and in person, to deliver this as a use case almost for how we could and should be running a hybrid meeting. It was a tremendous experience, and I very much enjoyed it to the extent that this really continued to give me the confidence that the future is a hybrid future. In person will certainly be useful. Online is certainly going to be helpful, but I do see a generic future for our district and beyond to be happening in a hybrid form, because it really gives the best of both worlds. Thank you, Martha.
That is a wonderful story that you are, that it's sort of giving me the background of how you could support us and be this spirit supporting the change. But how did you go about the process of embarking on hybrid meetings after that first meeting, that first hybrid meeting that you have just described, and why?
This is a great question. And actually, that probably takes me back to probably September last year, so just over a year ago, before I even attended the first hybrid meeting. When we were coming up with the idea of the hybrid future, one thing that I had in mind was, what do we need to have a hybrid future? What is the minimum viable product? What is the minimum base for a successful hybrid meeting? And back then, and it's something that actually I shared with my own club as I was sergeant at arms at the time, was a list of equipments, a list of, you know, a very basic set of, we need a camera, we need this, we need that, in order to have this experience. But it didn't really go much further than that at the time. But this is something that really gave me the confidence that not only it was possible, but certainly gave me the confidence that pretty much every club would be able to do it. Yes, there is some technical challenges that need to be overcome, but just like there are technical challenges to have an online meeting or an in-person meeting. If you forget the key to the church hall where you have your in-person meeting, as has happened to me when visiting a club once, it can be a challenge and you need to think on the spot, just like you do in any kind of meeting environment. So the reason I went back to this experience when I was sergeant at arms was also as a thought process. As a sergeant at arm, what would I need to do in order to enable my club to become a hybrid, but to become a club that performs on a regular basis hybrid meetings? And it was very much a thought exercise, because back in September last year, there was no way we were going to be in this position of doing the meeting in this format. But it was a practice. What do we need to do? Do we need to have some investment in place so that we are able to purchase a camera, purchase maybe a laptop or something else? And I'm really pleased to say that all of the clubs that actually ended up doing hybrid meetings before my own club pretty much followed a very similar pattern. And ultimately, this once again convinced me even more that the future is a hybrid future, where we can actually be present in a room, have some fun, be able to have our 3D life back, as many of us would like it to be, but at the same time be available online to have that complete inclusivity that also is a trademark of our clubs in District 91, but also our organization around the globe. So this is how I went about it. It was an idea. It was also born out of my role as sergeant at arms. And I'm very pleased to see that most clubs now are following a very similar pattern. And it's great to see that the technology has enabled so many of our clubs to experience this format.
How fantastic. And our listeners can certainly see how it is speaking to themselves. For example, we had an experience of forgetting batteries, AA batteries, to charge our microphone. This is all about it. Thank you, Arno. Mike Weston, another member of our hybrid committee, will ask you a couple of further questions. Over to Mike.
Thank you, Marta. Arno, you've talked about the challenges, and yet we're all fundamentally aware of the challenges. But when you actually got to that first hybrid meeting, you know, the first real Toastmasters hybrid meeting, did it turn out to be easier or more difficult than you expected? And why might that have been?
Well, I've got to say, my first experience in a hybrid meeting going back to the end of June, I will simply say Amwick speakers did what District 91 does best. They had pizza at that meeting. So to me, that made it so simple, so welcoming, that anything else that could have happened afterwards would have been simply a bonus. But joke aside, the technology, and this is actually what I also do as a profession, is sometimes it's nice to be able to hide the complexity behind systems, behind cameras, behind roles, so that the people in front, if you're in front of the microphone, you don't have to worry about the cameras pointing at you, you don't have to worry about the microphone working. So I think one of the biggest challenges that I've seen then, and I'm also continuing to notice today, is making sure that the clubs are having this process in place as a very well-oiled machine that essentially makes the experience completely transparent for the speakers, for the evaluators, and even for the guests, because let's not forget our guests. Having a hybrid meeting allows us to once again continue to have guests coming from all around the world. And I think that alone is certainly a huge opportunity that we need to continue to use across our district and beyond.
Thank you, Arno. So Arno, you've mentioned the demands of getting pizza, the demands of oiling the machine and making sure it runs smoothly. So what are these extra demands that are put on committee, and what can sometimes be the challenges for the in-person attendees?
That's a great question. So the extra demands on the committee, I would actually say there's no specific extra demand on the committee. I would argue that it becomes the role of the Sergeant at Arms to spin up a hybrid committee for the club and making sure that those with a technology background, those with video or sound backgrounds in the clubs are able to actually perform a particular role. As we've always had, the Sergeant at Arms role is there to support the club with the logistics activities. And in a hybrid environment, the logistics just gets a little bit bigger in terms of number of activities that need to be done. And therefore, it's a great opportunity. In fact, it's a great leadership opportunity for the Sergeant at Arms role to spin up this hybrid committee within the club in order to deliver all of those activities, from setting up the room to ensuring the technology works, to making sure that Zoom Masters exist both on the in-person activity, on the in-person setup, on the online setup. So there's always some kind of backup. And I would probably draw some kind of parallel, which is probably not the best parallel, but one that I remember when we had our first District 91 online conference in May 2020. The direction that I gave to the team at the time was, no matter what happens, every role needs to have a backup. And I think having a hybrid meeting definitely needs to follow that principle, because you never know what can happen. And internet connections can drop, microphone can suddenly die on you for some reason, cameras can be knocked off by somebody walking to the stage. You have no idea what can come up. But once again, this is the Toastmasters experience. We are here to practice our public speaking. We are here to practice our leadership skills. And there is nothing better than having an experience where something doesn't quite go to plan. But if you have those steps in place, if you have the committee behind you, if you have everybody in the club willing to step up and perform that extra role, or simply just take over when the time comes, when the technology issue happens, then the experience is all the better for the members, for the club, and for the organization as a whole.
Thank you, Arno. I think you've made a great case for this being an opportunity to deal with impromptu problems and develop one's leadership. I mean, if you can keep your head when all about themselves are losing theirs, then you will be a Toastmaster. And I feel that that is exactly why we should be doing these things. So we're back to some more questions for Marta.
Arno, to have a spare was your advice in the meeting, but can I now ask you about your view on the challenges going forward for the hybrid?
Sure. So the challenges are plentiful. And I would probably say that the challenges are equally, are very similar to the time when we moved to online meetings. The big question that most clubs are probably asking themselves is it sustainable? Can we continue to be a hybrid? Can we continue with hybrid meetings? Should we move back to in-person only? Should we move back to online only? So all of those questions are the biggest challenge that we have to face at the moment. And at the time of recording, we also live in a country that has tens of thousands of COVID cases, and who knows what our government is going to do and potentially impose further restrictions. We never know. So managing that level of uncertainty, once again, is a pretty exciting opportunity from a leadership perspective, because it's not about we meet in person and we're always going to be meeting in person. It's about we meet in a hybrid format. We meet in this format for the time being until something comes. Whatever that something is, do we have options? Do we have our plan A? Do we have our plan B? Do we have our plan C? And this is really what I would hope and expect and encourage all clubs to think about over the coming days, weeks, and months. Because if the last 18 months have taught us something, and the lesson is very simple, you never know what's around the corner. So as a club committee, your role is to really think ahead, what is best for the club, what is best for the members. And again, another challenge could be for those clubs that were very successful online and have attracted members from all around the globe. Moving to hybrid allows those clubs to be perfectly viable and continue to service those members from halfway around the planet. Now, if something changes, if the idea of hybrid meetings suddenly dies down for those that are in person only, then the challenge becomes, what is the future for those online members? Are we doing the best that we can to service all of the members of our clubs, of our areas, districts? And I think this is very much a challenging equation to resolve, because there is no right answer. Every club has to find their own solution for the benefit of the club members. And I will repeat that. Every club has to find the solution for their own needs. And just as every club is different, every member is different. Every member has joined a club for a very specific reason. And therefore, the solution needs to be tailored for the club. But having said all of this, I do see the hybrid format being a unique opportunity to be simply promoting our district, our organization, all around the globe, and something that we just could not do only 18 months ago when we were simply doing this, doing these meetings in person only. So I'm really excited about it. There are plenty of challenges, no doubt. But just like there are challenges in person or online only, life is a challenge.
Yeah, that is excellent. That is excellent answer. What if I asked you, what is a positive that hybrid meetings have, provided that neither online or in person could have? Is there something that hybrid has?
Well, this is going to sound very corny and almost like a cliche, but a hybrid meeting allows us to bring the worlds together much closer than it's ever been. Don't know about you, but 18 months ago, it never occurred to me to have a video call with a friend halfway around the world. Today, it's common practice, and it's common practice because we started doing this online and we continue to do it today in a hybrid environment. And I'll use my home club of Ken Speakers as an example. We have members from multiple countries. We have members from the United States. We have members from Canada. We have members from France, Switzerland, Mexico. We have visitors from Bangladesh, India, New Zealand, Australia, Singapore, the Philippines. Those types of interactions just cannot happen in an in-person format. And I think the richness and the wealth of knowledge and diversity that we can gain from this type of interaction is absolutely unique. And you might say, well, certainly we can have the same experience online. Absolutely. But online doesn't necessarily always give you that presence that you might have. It might not give you that ability to meet with sometimes very long time friends that you're longing to see again. But ultimately, the hybrid environment really allows all of us to cherish and nurture and create those long distance friendships that sometimes start during a break at in the middle of a meeting, having that casual conversation with somebody online. And you never know, we might all see each other again at the international convention in Nashville next August. You never know how where those meetings can take us.
Excellent, thank you. Mike, can you ask further questions, please?
Thank you, Marta, I certainly will. So we've learned over the last 18 months how to do a Toastmasters meeting online. We know how to do Toastmasters meetings in a room. You've touched on some points of this, but what in your view are the critical essentials to guarantee a successful hybrid Toastmasters meeting?
Passion. 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 If you're not passionate about what you do, nothing will ever happen. But ultimately, in order, let's talk, some of the technical aspect of a hybrid meeting. One of the most successful, and I've actually seen a video recently from a, I can't remember where that was. I'll try and find out this this link. It was a video expert of some description, perhaps from a TV channel or something. Anyway, that very much confirm what we've been saying actually in this organization for some time. It all starts with a good sound. You can easily get away with very poor camera, but if you have very poor sound, it's very easy to basically drop out and simply not be engaged at all and really not have a very good experience. So that is that is certainly probably the single most important element. So if you have any pounds left in the club budget to allocate to something, look for good quality microphones, plural, because you may want to have multiple microphones set up. But again, that's getting a bit technical, and you may not want to experience that just yet. But it all starts with good sound. And then the sky is the limit. You can have multiple cameras set up that allows you to have the speaker, the room, multiple take on the speaker from side to from front to side. You can buy a gimbal to have some kind of roaming shots along the way during a meeting to almost create a TV experience. But I'm being carried away here. We're not here to necessarily become TV broadcasters, but you know what? Why not? Maybe some will find a new career and find a new passion to explore.
Thank you, Arno, and I think you're spot on. Why should there be boundaries within Toastmasters? We're all here to improve ourselves, and there should never be any limits on that. I entirely behind your point, 100%. So again, we're talking about meetings. We're talking about how you've trialed meetings, you've been along to meetings, but what criteria have you put in place, or have you seen put in place to judge if the format for these meetings is successful?
I think for me, and again, I'm probably a little bit biased as a first president education of my own club, but so from that very perspective, I place a very strong belief that a successful hybrid meeting is a meeting where you have a relatively equal treatment of online and in-person members. And by equal treatment, I don't mean having 10% online, 10% in a room. I mean having speakers, evaluators, role takers, both online and in person, and not restricting a particular type of role for a particular type of attendance. You can be a Toastmaster online or in person. You can be a timekeeper online or in person. You can be any role in either format. And to me, that is a very strong definition of what I see as a successful hybrid meeting, making sure that there is no artificial boundaries, artificial limits placed on you are online, you cannot do this, or you're in person, we must not do that. It's all about being able to do any role in any environment. And ultimately, this is very much the inclusivity and once again, the diversity that we're looking for and trying to reach as an organization.
Again, Neil, that's again what Toastmasters is all about. It is breaking down barriers, making people the best they can be, leveling everyone up. So yes, you should never be pulling people down by putting pointless sort of restrictions on what they can do, when we should be trying to raise everyone up and make it at the best meeting we can do without any problem. So again, couldn't agree with you more. So over to Marta.
Thank you, Mike. Arnaud, now I would like to ask you, what advice would you give to members, to people reluctant to experiment with the hybrid meetings?
Try it. Experience it. Life is an experience. And that's actually the way I live my own life. It's very difficult to be against something, to disagree with something, if you've not experienced that something. So being able to attend a meeting, and in fact, we have our meeting at Ken Speakers in a hybrid format next Wednesday. So if you want to experience it for the first time, you can join us from all around the world. But that aside, experience is actually where the learning starts, because you never know the challenge. And once again, everybody might have challenges and maybe thinking, well, I don't really want to be involved in a technical side of running a hybrid meeting. I'm not sure it could work. Well, we have plenty of examples already that demonstrate that it can work. The technology, it's almost an accessory. There will always be somebody in the club that will be there to support you. And if there isn't, it's a great opportunity to learn. And that to me is probably one of the biggest benefit. But first and foremost, try and experience the hybrid meeting. Find somebody perhaps ahead of time to give you a bit of their own experience as well. And we have many clubs around our district and around the world that have held hybrid meetings so far. So the experience is out there. Take a look at the articles on the Toastmasters International magazine. Look at the videos. We have members of district, I believe, 109 that have put on plenty of videos online from months and months ago, talking about hybrid setups, hybrid meetings. So there's plenty of resources already out there to give you that confidence that it's not only a good idea, but it's also a great experience.
Superb. Absolutely superb. Thank you. And what is your best hybrid experience so far?
Well, I have to be very biased and I cannot say anything other than my last club meeting at Ken Speakers. Once again, we're meeting next Wednesday. So if you want to join us, feel free to do so. But the reason I, you know, classify it as the best is not so much because it's my own club, but it's also when I see how everybody is stepping up to do every role during the meeting. I arrived, and I'll give you a little story. So I arrived about 20 minutes before the meeting started, well after our first members starting to set up the room, starting to set up the computers, the cameras, the sound. And I arrived at almost a crisis point where suddenly a microphone doesn't work because we're missing a cable. You know, those things do happen. But one of our members came up with his own microphone. So we had the backup. We could have also had a backup from the microphone on the computer and so on. But going through that experience was actually a nice experience to see how our members are working together to create the best possible experience before most members arrive and essentially still provide that quality meeting. And that really talks to what I was saying a little bit earlier around hiding the complexity behind the technology. The technology is an enabler. The technology is not about what we're doing. The technology allows us to do what we do. But also during the meeting, we had a good blend of online participation, in-person participation. We had guests both online and in person. So really, from that perspective, we really ticked all the boxes that I see are important. And we even managed, I believe, to sign up or about to sign up both members online and in person that were attending our meeting. So I think that's certainly a positive and a win for us as a club, but also for all of us as an organization. And last but not least, it's just a great experience being able to be in a room, see the same people that we've seen sometimes for the past year and a half online and continue to have that experience. It's unique. And if you probably ask me 6 months, a year, 2-3 years down the line, I'll probably say, well, this is probably still the best experience that I have. Allows us to keep those connections from around the globe right there within District 91. And I think for that alone, I would just not have it any other way.
That is excellent. I love the fact that actually your great experience has been after something failed. So seeing how the thing that are actually erroneous, how can we manage to make it work? It is just a wonderful, magnificent highlighter of the experience. Thank you very much, Arno. And over to Mike now.
Thank you, Marta. So Arno, you've talked about the meetings, you've talked about, you know, people facing challenges, but Toastmasters is an organization about learning and teaching and developing. What transferable skills do you think our members can develop by running hybrid meetings that perhaps they might not in normal meetings?
Raise your hand if you work somewhere. Raise your other hands if you happen to work with people in different offices. Those experiences that we have within our Toastmasters meeting, whether they were in person, whether they are online, whether they are hybrid experiences, give us that unique opportunity to not necessarily learn, but certainly get better at what we do, perhaps sometimes every day in our jobs, in our lives. And certainly the last 18 months have seen tremendous changes in the way we work, in the way we live, in the way we communicate with one another. And what we do within Toastmaster is simply a mirror image. I know I have had these home activities where suddenly you call a few friends and you have yourself in a room with a few friends in another room. So that's a hybrid meeting. We've had one-to-one video conferences. That may not necessarily be hybrid, but we're all in a physical 3D environment. So those are the experiences that that I value the most. And I think the experience that is gained is valuable for our personal lives, for our professional lives. And ultimately, it gives the opportunity for those of us that are not necessarily confident yet in having that lifestyle, that we can do it. And then once again, this is what this organization is all about. We're here to learn new skills. And as the world has changed beyond any kind of recognition in the last 18 months, we still value that in-person element. We still value the ability to talk to somebody from halfway around the globe. But first and foremost, we continue to value the learning opportunity. And to tie this with our education program, we have this unique opportunity to deliver projects that sometimes could have been perhaps more difficult in our legacy environment of having everything in person. Very difficult to have to run an online meeting in an in-person environment. So certainly we have plenty of skills here to enable us to become more proficient in our work environment, be able to make friends with people from anywhere in a way that we just could not do only 18 months ago. So once again, I'm very upbeat and I really, really believe that the future is hybrid. So thank you for asking.
I would have to agree. I mean, this is opening so many doors, and that's what Toastmasters, as you say, is all about. It's about opening doors for people, particularly in the work environment. So many of our members come here to improve their job opportunities, sort of give them more skills that can get take them into whole new directions. And hybrid is just a way for the future. I mean, this was always going to happen one way or the other. I think the pandemic has probably driven it forward a little earlier than people might expect. And Toastmasters has always been at the cutting edge, as you've said. So fundamentally, yeah, I can only once again agree. So you've touched on this previously. I mean, looking forward to 18 months time, but really, what do you think, you know, if you could tell us your vision for the best possible outlook you would predict or expect for hybrid meetings within the coming year, what would that be?
Challenges aside, I think the next 18 months are going to be interesting. Interesting in the sense that we are entering this period of time where I actually believe that hybrid will become the norm, not just for Toastmasters meeting, but for pretty much any interactions. And we start to see that in business. We start to see that in almost commercial environments as well. Yes, in-person continues to be there. Yes, online only is there too. But this hybrid environment is that missing link. Is that something that was always, as you just said, always going to happen? It just happened much faster than it would otherwise happen. So if I fast forward 18 months, I can see our clubs, I can see many of our districts around the globe embrace the hybrid environment. And perhaps to varying degrees, depending on your locations and membership. But ultimately, I do see that this hybrid meeting type will continue to be thriving, not just within District 91, but also far beyond. I actually think that also the next 18 months would be our greatest learning opportunity, because we have adapted very fast to become online as an organization. And I think the next 18 months will do pretty much the same thing in a hybrid environment. We will learn how to master cameras and sound and multiple laptops and figuring out pretty much anything that can go wrong in those environments. And when I see the speed at which my own club has been able to adapt to this environment, one test meeting and off we go. We are ready to go without pretty much any glitches that are perceivable from an attendance perspective. To me, that bodes well for the future. And this is where I see this organization going. This is where I see our meetings going. And once again, this is where I believe the future lies, in a truly hybrid fashion, not just in Toastmasters, but around any interaction.
Thank you, Arno. I think that's a compelling vision. And certainly you've outlined the Toastmasters place within that vision incredibly well. I think we would all want to be a part of that. And as you say, I think people are making those first steps. Some people are taking the lead, some people are following them up, but it'll be a fantastically interesting 18 months as we transition away from an enforced online environment into an environment where we can seize the opportunities that we want rather than having them thrust upon us. So thank you very much for your time this evening, Arno. You've given us a fascinating insight into your hybrid journey. You've taken us down exciting paths of discovery. I'm sure the people who watch this video will get a lot out of that. So I'd just like to thank you once again for your time this evening, Arno.
Thank you very much. It's been my pleasure, and keep up the great work. It's been amazing.
And I'd also like to thank my fellow committee member, Marta, for some of the questions.
Thank you. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Arno. It was really inspirational to be witnessing this process. I cannot believe we are doing it, but it is happening.